Good day, young entrepreneur. Welcome to Itulay, your online tutorial platform that will help us answer. That will help us answer our module. Na ida-download po natin from Debt and Commons. And today, with me is my tutor mentee, Tutor Mel from SDO Palawan, Coron School's Officialist, na magbibigay sa inyo ng mga additional learnings and key takeaways para po sa ating subject sa entrepreneurship. And of course, today is the last Friday of the month and we are here again to study our module. So ihanda po natin ang ating mga modules, pencil and pen, para po sabay-sabay po nating sagutan ang ating activity dito po sa subject na entrepreneurship. Magandang umaga sa iyo, Tutor Mel. And of course, magandang umaga sa ating pong mga viewers.
Magandang umaga po, Tutor Wax. Yes. Muli, magandang umaga sa lahat ng ating mga online learners na napatuloy na nakasubaybay dito lang sa ating DepEd Itulay online tutorial platform.
Yes. So, this is our lesson last week. I believe no, tayo po ay nasa quarter seven. We are now in week six. So, week six, no. Last week, week six. And then today is week seven. So, nung week six natin, let's have a review. No, bigyan natin ng mga review ang ating mga learners kung ano po ang ating mga pinag-aralan nung nakaraang Friday.
Yes, Tutor Wax, tama ka dyan. So, let's review. So, last Business Friday, napag-aralan natin yung customers in terms of target market, customers requirements, and market size.
Wow. So nakita po natin no, ang mga additional learnings po na ating pong matutunan dito po sa Itulay. No? Napag-aralan po natin yung ating target market. So na-identify na natin kung sino yung mga target market natin at ano yung kanilang mga requirement and then ang ating pong market size. Kasi we are in preparation also in making our business plan. Kasi sa next quarter po natin, we will have the implementation of our business. And then, yung paghahandaan po natin sa pag-record po ng ating mga business transaction. Okay? Tama and for this week, tatapusin po natin ang ating lesson. No? Para po, bago tayo magbakasyon, ay ma-ready po natin ang ating mga isasubmit na mga activities sa ating pong mga eskwelahan. So magandang umaga po sa lahat ng Schools Division Office ng buong Pilipinas, ng DepEd. Yes. Magandang umaga po sa ating mga kaguruan sa entrepreneurship at sa ating pong mga learners. Magandang umaga sa ating viewers din na si Tutor Mark Edward na nakikinig at nanonood mula sa SDO Mamalakad City, Pampanga. Magandang umaga po. Yes. Now, let's move on now with our discussion. Also kay Tutor RJ, no, Mayap Abak po. Okay, Kapampangan, Mayap Abak po. Okay.
Aba. So magandang
para po sa ating viewers, no, para po sa ating mga viewers sa ating pong module reference ay makukuha po natin sa DepEd Commons. Napunta lamang po kayo doon at makikita niyo po doon ang ating pong mga materials na gagamitin po natin for this morning. Okay, Tutor Mel. So let's discuss now with our topic for this morning.
Yes, Tutor Wax, muli tayo po ay nasa quarter 1 week 7. Our topic for today ay market research.
Ayan. Market research na tayo.
Yes po. Ayan. So bago tayo mag-start, let's first identify our objectives for this morning. So at the end of our tutorial, number one, explain what market research is. Number two, understand the meaning of data gathering. Number three, identify the different data gathering techniques. And number four, appreciates the importance of market research. Ayan po yung ating pag-aaralan for this morning.
Actually, kasabay po yan ng ating pong DepEd TV. No? Yung mga lesson po na yan ay maaaring nyo rin pong makita at mapanood sa DepEd TV. So, punta lamang po kayo sa YouTube no? At saka sa IBC 30. No? Kasi kasabay po yung lesson po na yan ng ating pong anthrop subject. Okay? So I think you can start na, Tutor Mel. Take it away, Tutor Mel. For our lesson.
Thank you so much, Tutor Wax. Muli, magandang umaga sa lahat po ng ating mga online learners. Good morning po kay Mega Regaspi. Present daw po siya from Coron School of Fisheries. Good morning. Ayan. So before we start our discussion for this morning, let us first have an activity. So before starting, so alamin natin kung ano na ba yung idea natin patungkol dito po sa ating activity. So just encircle the correct letter na inyong napili. So let's start with number one. Ayan, Shooter Box, nandiyan ka pa?
Nandito pa ako. Okay. So, sa ating number one, no, it is the most common way to gather primary data with the use of questionnaires or interview schedule. So, ano kaya po yan? Ano ating mga selection, Shooter Mel?
Yes, letter A, interview. Letter B, focus group discussion. Letter C, survey. Or letter D, data gathering. Ano kaya ang sagot natin for this question number one? Sige nga, comment your answer in our comment section. Ayan. Ayan. Ang sabi nila, letter C, survey. Very good. Survey po ang ating sagot with question number one. Let's continue with number three. Letter C. Ayan. So, it is the traditional method of data collection which is normally done personally with the respondents. Traditional daw na ginagawa natin for us to be able to get information. Ano kaya to? A, personal interview. Letter B, focus group discussion. Letter C, survey. Letter D, data gathering. Ano kaya sagot natin with number two question? Ayan, sabi po ni Mark Edward, letter A. Tama. Okay, let's continue with number three question. It refers to information gathered directly from respondents who answer a set of questions. May mga questions tayong binigay. Ano kaya ito? Primary research, secondary research, survey, or data gathering? Sabi ni Mika, letter A. Ayun, ang gagaling ng ating mga online learners. Muli po, pwede nyo pong i-share ang ating pong live for this morning para sa inyong mga classmates din at mailaman nila kung ano ba ang market research. Okay, let's continue with number four question. A data gathering techniques where it can be done via direct mail, over the phone, or internet, or email. Ano kaya itong klaseng data gathering na to? Okay, sabi ni Mika ulit, letter B. Sabi ni Mark Edward, letter B. Tama. Ang sagot ninyo, yan ay survey. Okay, let's continue with number five. It refers to the process of data gathering or process of gathering data, analyzing and interpreting the information about the product or the service to be offered for sale in the market. Ano kaya ito? Ang sagot ni Sir Wax, letter D. Yes, tama. That is market research. And for now, we're going to really understand why that's are the answer for the previous activity that we have. So, our topic for today is about marketing research or market research. Ayan, di ba? I-research natin. Sabi nga, research is an systematic investigation. Di ba? Systematic, ibig sabihin ng systematic, merong process na ginagawa. Okay, let's define what is marketing research. Market research or marketing research process can be identified as the process of gathering, analyzing, and interpreting the information about the product or services to be offered for sale to the potential consumers in the market. So, ibig sabihin, ginagawa natin itong marketing research before tayo magbenta ng mga produkto sa ating mga consumers, or kaya naman meron na tayong existing products, gusto lang natin pagandahin para mas provide talaga natin ang produkto na gusto ng ating mga consumers. Remember, kaya tayo nagbi-business is because of our consumers. Tama? Okay, let's continue. In marketing research, meron tayong tinatawag na data collection. What is data collection? Data collection is the most valuable tool in any type of research study. Data collection, remember, ito yung time na tayo ay kukuha na ng mga information sa ating mga consumers. Ayan, inaccurate and data collection may cause mistakes and ultimately leads to invalid result. Ayan, kaya dapat tama yung pagkuha natin ng ating mga information or data para maging accurate din yung ating information o result na makukuha para sa ikagaganda ng business na ating itatayo. Okay? Let's continue. Tips in data collection. Meron tayong mga tips na dapat nating isaalang-alang every time that we are gathering data. First, organize collected data as soon as it is available. Dapat organize. Kaya nga, di ba, systematic. Ibig sabihin, may process na kinasinasabayan. Number two, know what message you want to get across and then collect data that is relevant to the message. Kailangan alam mo kung ano yung kailangan mo lang para doon ka direct to the point sa pangangailangan mo. Di ba? Ayan, good morning po kay Sir John. Direct watching from SDO Angeles City, Pampanga. Good morning, sir. Ayan, and letter next natin is collect more data. The more data that you collect, the more the information is being true. And create more data. Mag-create ka. Kailangan talaga gumawa ka ng maraming data that is accurate to the needs of your consumers or customers. Okay? Take note of interesting or significant data. Dapat naka-note yun yung mga mahalaga at importanteng data na kailangan natin. Okay, so we have three types of different data collection. We have number one, survey or questionnaire. Number two, we have interview. Number three, focus group discussion. So these three is the most important or commonly used in collecting data. So let's start with number one, which is survey or questionnaire. Ayan, ano ba yung survey questionnaire? Are the most common way to gather primary research with the use of questionnaires or interview schedule. Ayan, so survey the most common. Remember the word, most common in primary research. Ayan, so may mga questionnaires tayong ginagawa for us to be able to really get the information that we wanted from our consumers. Okay, and we have methods of survey. So we have face-to-face or on-web. Example is Skype or Viber. We have direct mail. We have internet or Google or email. And we have over the phone, pwede nating tawagan. And of course, on the web, the example Skype or Viber. Tandaan po natin na tayo ay merong questionnaires na prepare for us to be able to get or gather the information needed from our consumers. Okay? So, when designing or constructing your research questionnaire, remember the following guidelines. So, tandaan po natin, hindi lang tayo basta-basta gumagawa ng questionnaires. Dapat meron tayong sinasabayang guidelines. Which is number one, keep it simple as possible. Dapat simple yung mas naiintindihan ng ating mga consumers. Kasi yung iba sa kanila ay medyo tamad magsagot o sumagot. Diba? Then, make it sure it is clearly appealing and easy to read. Diba? Madaling maintindihan. No? And, syempre, next natin, cluster or block-related question. Dapat meron tayong mga question. Kunyari, about demographic profile, age, names nila, about sa needs nila, dapat naka-cluster yun. Hindi siya pwedeng gulo-gulo. Kaya nga sabi natin, it should be systematic. Okay? Next, we have move from complex question to more specific. So from mahirap to most specific question, yung madali na lang intindihin or naka-specific talaga sa pangangailangan nating information, na kailangan nating information. Make sure questions are concise and easily understood, madaling intindihin at maikli lang. And syempre, avoid questions that are difficult to answer. Importante yan. And make sure response skills used are consistent with categories that are mutually exclusive. Okay, so yun po yung mga tips na dapat nating tandaan every time that we are making our questionnaires for our consumers. And let's continue with number two types of data gathering. So we have interview is one of the most reliable and credible ways of getting relevant information from target customers. Ito daw yung what most reliable, ibig sabihin makatotohanan, di ba? And yan po yung interview natin. Okay, so interview is also helpful even when business has already started, di ba? Because customers' feedback, pwede nating makuha because of interview, pwede nating matanong the entrepreneur or glimpse of what consumers or customers think about the business. Ayan. Okay, interview natin yun. No? Interview normally lasts for 15 to 40 minutes but can last longer depending on the participant's interest. Yan. Dapat 15 minutes to 40 minutes lang siya. Pero kung mas magiging maganda yung topic at mas naiintindihan ng consumers at nagkakaroon kayo ng interaction, pwedeng tumagal pa ito ng 40 minutes or more than that. Diba? A constructed interview, the researcher asks a standard set of questions and more, nothing more. Dapat may set na questionnaires ka rin every time that we are conducting interview with our consumers. And we have types of or methods of interview. Number one, personal interview. are the traditional method of conducting an interview. It allows the researcher to establish the relationship with potential participants and therefore gain their cooperation. Okay, personal interview natin yan. And next natin is telephone naman, via telephone. Ano yan? Less expensive daw tong telephone, sorry. Less expensive and less time consuming. But disadvantage are the response rate is not as high as the face-to-face interview, but considerable higher than the mail questionnaires. Okay, via telephone, tinatawagan natin yung ating mga consumers na i-interviewin natin. Okay, and next natin is we have number three types of data gathering or data collection is what we call the focus group discussion. Ano po ba itong focus group discussion na sinasabi? Ayan. It is an excellent method for generating and screening ideas and concept. It can be moderated group interviews in brainstorming sessions that provides information on users' needs and behaviors. Okay, yan. Ibig sabihin, nag-grupo tayo dito kung saan. Sabi doon, excellent method for generating and screening ideas. Diba? Lahat ng sinabi natin na tatlong magkakaiba na mga data gathering procedures ay mayroong importanteng aspect sa atin. Okay? Ayan. So the following are consideration in the use of focus group discussion in the market research. Ito daw po, number one, the length of session is between 90 and 120 minutes. Dapat nandyan lang, hindi nalalampas. No? Next, conduct group discussion with 8 to 10 participants per group. Dapat 8 to 10 lang. And next, assign an expert moderator, facilitator who can manage group dynamics. Dapat meron tayong moderator para hindi maging boring yung ating discussion about doon sa ating focus group discussion. And next natin is use a semi-constructed or open mind, open format discussion. Dapat open format para hindi tayo lang nasa, sabi nga, dapat we should be outside the box, diba? And strives for consistency in the group composition. Example, it may be advisable to have business customers and retail customers in the same focus group discussion. Their needs are very different. So dapat iba't ibang sector, iba't ibang types of consumers. Meron tayong wholesaler, retailer, and syempre yung ating mga business consumers natin. Para mas maintindihan talaga natin kung ano yung need ng ating consumers. Remember, market research is all about data gathering. It's all about getting information from our consumers. And let's discuss first or recap the three different types of data collection. We have survey or questionnaires, number two, interview, and number three, focus group discussions. Ayan! And of course, we already discussed everything about the marketing research, about the different data collection. Now, we will having an assessment. Okay? So we finished the module. So answer the question given below by encircling the correct answer. Okay, we have number one question. Okay, number one, it is the traditional method of data collection, which is normally done in person with the respondents. Okay, personal interview, focus group discussion, survey, or data gathering. Sige nga, comment your answer in our comment section para malaman natin kung ano po ang sagot natin dito sa ating question number one. Ang sabi po dyan, traditional method, sabi natin kanina, na-discuss na natin yun kung ano yung traditional method natin. Okay, ang sagot po ni Wax, ni Sir Wax ay letter A. Ang sabi ni Mark, letter A. Okay, tama. Diba? Personal interview is the traditional method. Ibig sabihin ng traditional method, makalumang method na kung saan, kung paano natin makakonsider o makakaget ng information about sa ating mga consumers. Okay, let's continue with number two question. It is one of the most reliable and credible way of getting relevant information from target customers. Sabi ni Mira, letter A daw sa number one. Ano kaya ito? Most reliable and credible? Kanina, nasabi natin yan. Diba? Ano kaya? Primary research, secondary research, interview, or data gathering? Ayan, ang sabi po ni Mark Edward, letter C, most reliable. Interview daw, sabi ni Mira, letter C. Sabi ni John, letter C. Sabi ni Mira, letter si very good, ang gagaling ng ating mga online learners. Nakuha nila ang tamang sagot, interview, which is the most reliable and credible way of getting relevant information. Next, let's continue with number 3 question. Data gathering techniques where it can be done via direct mail, over the phone, internet, or email. Nasabi natin ito kanina. Data gathering ba? Survey, focus group discussion, or personal interview? Ano kayang sagot natin dito? Sabi ni Kish Kate, letter B daw, survey. Sabi ni Mark Edward, letter B. Sabi ni Kyle, letter B. Sabi ni Huge, letter B. Tama, very good, letter B. Diba? So sabi natin kanina sa definition natin, doon sa ating unang type of data gathering techniques, which is survey. Okay, let's continue with number 4. Ito na, ayan. It is the process of data gathering, analyzing, and interpreting the information about the product or the services to be offered for sale in the market. So the market and about past, present, and potential consumers for the product. Ano kaya itong number 4 question natin? The process of gathering. Diba? Gather, ginagather natin yung mga information. At syempre, sabi nga natin, gathering information without analyzing it is useless. So, kailangan i-analyze din natin. And sunod natin is kailangan i-interpret natin yung information. So, what is our answer for number 4? Data gathering, primary research, secondary research, or market research. Ano kayang sagot natin dito with question number 4? Ayan, ano kayang sagot natin? Ayan, sabi ni Mira, letter D daw. Sabi ni Mark, letter D. Sabi ni Kish Kate, letter D. Sabi ni John, letter D. Ni Mark, letter D. Ayan, ano kaya? Tama, letter D, market research or marketing research. Ang sabi natin kanina, di ba? Which is the process of gathering, analyzing, and interpreting the information about the product or services to be offered for sale in the market. When we say in the market, market refers to our consumers where we are going to sell our product. Sabi ni Kiskate, letter D. Very good ang uhusay ng ating mga online learners. And continue tayo with number 5. Ito na po tayo with number 5 question. It is an excellent method for generating and screening ideas and concepts. Excellent method daw para maka-generate tayo ng at ma-screen natin yung idea and concept. Ano kaya ito? Na-discuss natin, which is I think ito yung ating huling type ng data gathering or data collection. Ano kaya? Data gathering, survey, focus group discussion, or personal interview. Ano kayang sagot natin dito? Excellent method, no? Kung saan nagbi-brainstorming dito yung ating mga respondents o mga tao na kinuha natin para magtulong-tulong para ma-identify talaga natin kung ano yung pangangailangan ng ating mga consumers. Okay, ano kayang sagot natin dito? Ang sabi ni Elvin ay letter D. Ang sabi ni Mira, letter C. Ang sabi ni Joshua, letter C. Ang sabi ni James, letter C. Okay, tama. Very good. The answer is letter C, which is focus group discussion. It is the most excellent or of way of generating and screening idea. Tama si Mira. Napakahusay. Salamat. Si Mamira talaga ay very active natin na participants dito sa ating online tutorial sa subject na entrepreneurship. Maraming salamat, Mira. Ayan, muli po. Magkita-kita tayo sa susunod na Business Friday, 11 to 11:30 a.m. sa subject na entrepreneurship. Ako si Tutor Mel from SDO Palawan, together with me, Tutor Wax from SDO Olongapo City, na nagsasabing kaalaman sa pagninegosyo, ating pagyamanin. Ayan, para po sa inyong mga suwisyon, suggestion, or feedback, pwede nyo pong iscan ang ating QR code or kaya naman ay mag-email sa ating edtech@deved.com.ph. Ayan, Ang inyo po mga suwisyon ay napaka-importante sa amin, ang inyong mga feedback para sa ikakaganda ng ating online tutorial platform. Maraming maraming salamat po, Mamira, at sa lahat ng patuloy na kasama namin na sumusubaybay dito sa ating online tutorial platform. Maraming salamat. Magkita-kita tayo muli sa susunod na Business Friday. God bless you all.